It's never hard to find a hustler. Their habits are simple and unchanging. They consistently gather at the same corners and dress, walk, and talk in an easily recognizable style. A remarkable uniformity, actually, considering the variety of tastes they have to please. We picked one, arbitrarily, and followed him. A lucky choice, as it turned out. He was almost totally oblivious to the camera, even at much later stages of the experiment. I wanted to capture on film a complete record of one of these youths' behavior, not only to preserve my observations of him, but to serve as an accurate record of the entire experiment, and later on, to use in the experiment itself. Research has shown these youths to be incorrigibly amoral. Isolated at the bottom of society, they seem immune to the normal processes of development. Sexual, and in a sense psychological outlaws, they live in a state of primitive confusion, for having no standards by which to define themselves, they remain undefined, aware of themselves only as a physical entity. Last year, when funds became available to the Institute for studies in reconstructive psychiatry, that is, the radical alteration of an individual's personality, I was among the first to suggest acquiring several of these youths as subjects. After a period of observation, I can easily determine, as in this case, a suitable subject. I then have one of our men approach him and persuade him to join us, although we found it best not to mention our purposes or the Institute in the beginning.
I'm 19. I've been a hustler for 3 years. During that time, I've had no permanent home and no steady income other than what I could earn on the streets, and I have no education. I've been involved in several petty crimes, and I've been arrested 11 times on vagrancy charges, and I've spent a total of 41 days in jail. As far as I can determine, I have no future. Realizing that fact, I agree to submit myself to the care of the Institute of Neuropsychiatry as a volunteer for psychological reconditioning. I understand and agree that the Institute shall use me as a subject of medical tests of their choice for a period of at least 1 month. At the end of that time, I may discontinue the relationship or volunteer for additional periods. I release unconditionally my legal rights to any films, pictures, or recordings, or other testing data that may be made about me during my residency. I agree to cooperate fully with the staff of the Institute, and in all experiments, I absolve the Institute of responsibility for any psychological discomfort which may befall me as a result of these experiments. And I wish to thank the responsible parties for granting me this opportunity to serve humanity and assume a responsible position in society.
We're quite fortunate to have the film equipment now. It really is the most important aspect of our work. The televisions help, too. They don't have the mobility, the freedom necessary to thorough observation. Soon we will be able to expand, study more than one patient at a time, and maintain total coverage, 24 hours a day. Later on, of course, the patients will be shown all of these films, so they can watch and in a sense participate objectively in their own progress. And of course, more films will be made of their reactions, and they will in turn be shown these. Quite an intriguing process. It's quite simple what we do, really. We change their concept of themselves. By means of a simple mechanical device, we condition them to dislike themselves, or at least an image of themselves. Being vain, they are smugly satisfied with their bodies, their faces, even their costumes. But we can change all that. In a sense, we erase the image they formed of themselves on the street and construct a new image based on their life in the Institute. It's a shame these boys cannot really appreciate what we're doing for them. This case, for example, so typical. He thinks it's a holiday, a lark. Fortunately, I don't mind the simplicity of these youths. At times, it's even refreshing. Some research is so dry. This project, from the beginning, has been very, very stimulating. There. His first film therapy is about to begin. He's surprised and pleased to see himself on the screen. They always are. We usually give them a minute to enjoy themselves before we start the treatment. It's quite painless. That's a Westinghouse Portoshock. It distributes the current equally throughout the body. No local burns or anything. He'll learn not to smile at himself, and after a while, not to like himself at all. He is responding nicely. Yes, he is. I think perhaps we hit him with a little too much on that last one. Watch how he reacts to me, or rather, the camera, when the lights go up. Little devil. We had to jolt him. Camera discipline is of the utmost importance at this stage. It doesn't hurt him at all, really. He'll learn. And quickly, too, I think. Be out of here in no time. Then we'll move him over to the post-reconstruction wing. We've got an excellent monitoring system over there. He'll be no trouble.